yeah, international, underground, thunderbound, when I stop the ground, like a million elephants, a silverback, orangutan, you can't stop a train.
Hey everybody, welcome to Rack Vet Racing. Coming to you this clip, this is going to be the CKNA South Division down there at Monticello Karting, about an hour outside of Tallahassee, Florida. Really cold day, but this is going to be the Masters Final. Now, leading in this weekend for me, I had one of the worst weekends I've had in a long time. A lot of mechanical issues, snapping throttle cables to brakes that were so touchy. I was Mario Karting it anytime I had to apply the brake. Had a lot of issues this weekend and missed qualifying because of some of those issues. So here I am starting out in the back. Now, one of the things that I'll tell you, if you guys haven't done a CKNA event and you're new to this sport like I am, go. Definitely go out there. You will get more experience at one of these events than you will almost any other place that you could ever run. So can't speak highly enough for the event. The coordination of the staff, everything is great. I will also tell you that if you're running locals and they run kind of loose time slots, they do not do that at CKNA. If your race says that it starts at 9:34 a.m. and you show up on grid at 9:35, you have missed it. So just a little word of the wise. But we're about to go out here and do the warm-up lap. Again, I was messing around with my brakes a lot leading up to this. I had spun out on a couple of the other heat races. My brakes were just way too touchy. And so I kind of got with some of the TB Kart guys that were out there. A lot of them helped me out, you know, showed me how to adjust some of those brakes and take some of that play out of there. And so anyway, so we're getting going. I mean, I'm hoping at this point that all my issues have worked out. I felt like I had issues all weekend, but a lot of it also was just me. I mean, I'm just new to this, and quite frankly, I suck. So it is what it is. So. In this race right here, most of your winners were, we were doing the clockwise with the chicane. It's a 1.1 mile track. Monticello is fantastic. It's a drafting track. It's a wide track. It's a long track. And CKNA takes, you know, some of these people that show up for these races. I mean, these are some of the fastest guys, at least in the Southeast. But we had people in this race that had traveled, I think, as far as Minnesota. So CKNA for a four cycle race, I mean, they track some of the fastest drivers in the country. So, you know, me being new to the sport, you know, I'm trying to mix it up with these guys as best I can. But the fact of the matter is I'm just most of the time out of my league. But, you know, Monticello being my home track, I thought maybe I might have a little bit of a advantage, although ever slight. Now we just, started this race. Now going into that corner, everybody was taking it two and three wide in the races leading up to this. So I was real timid and because of all the wrecks. So I had a horrible start and I was a little too passive. Lost a lot of positions right off the bat. But, I mean, it is what it is. At this point, I just wanted to finish a race. Most of these races I was not finishing either due to mechanical or because I was spinning out or whatever it had be. But, yeah, I was just looking to put in a full 15 laps, 20 laps, I forget whatever this one was. But anyway, so here I am kind of going through it. This guy, another TB Kart guy, another veteran, Warbly right here in front of me. Nice guy, met him that weekend. Again, he's one of the TB Kart guys out of Florida. For those of you that don't know, TB Kart, they don't advertise it very well, but there's a lot of veterans that run TB Kart here in Florida. They are one of the only chassis manufacturers that I know of that does a lot of donations to veteran center charity, and so they do have a tendency to have a little bit of a following for the U.S. veteran community, and they don't like to brag about it. Something I wish they would probably do a little bit more, you know, just outlining how they, you know, help out the veteran community. But, for whatever reason, they decide that they want to keep that to themselves and not advertise that. And, you know, that's noble, but, you know, there's a lot of us in Florida, a lot of veterans and a lot of us run TB Kart. And it's not just for that reason. They put together an outstanding product, but, you know, thank you for your service is cute, but you know, when companies really start putting their money where their mouth is and starts helping out us veterans, you know, that tends to go a long way. So anyway, I'll get off that one. But yeah, so Warbly up here. So he was having some issues this weekend as well. I don't think he'd ever run this track before. He's not from this area. And I know he had a busted data logger, and he was on some really old tires. He didn't swap out new tires for the race. He's generally a very, very fast guy, and I think in one of the qualifyings, I think he got a 109 something. So he was pushing probably some of the fastest lap times, but for whatever reason, he was struggling. I know he did some gearing changes coming up here into the final, and his gearing changes really didn't seem to be working out for him. But again, just being another TB car guy, you know, we're starting out there in the back. I figured, you know, let's work together as much as we can. There's Warbly. I told him before this race when I was following him, he was taking that corner. Very, very bad. But anyway, he's generally a lot more experienced than I am. Again, I've only been doing this for probably less than a year. But, you know, at this point, I go ahead and I initiate the pass on Warbly. My thought process was he's probably a faster driver than me, but I'm more experienced on this track. So, you know, maybe following him might not be the best thing for us to do. Maybe if I get out in front, he can follow my line a little bit, know where he needs to place the cart on the track, and maybe we can work together and catch that group that's right up there in front. Now, a lot of these guys in this race are just stupid fast. Like I said, you know, to get on podium, a lot of these guys are in the 109s, 110, low 110s. That is just flying for a 206 on this track. You know, generally, I'm usually pushing around the 111s to 112s on average. If I get the draft, I might be a little bit faster, but I'm nowhere near these guys' skill level. So, but again, that's one of the reasons why I do these CKNA events, because they are just stocked with talent, and you can just learn a lot if you're willing to, you know, talk to the guys, ask them questions, you know, watch their lines, watch what they do. You can learn a lot. And so that's really what I was trying to do when I entered these CKNA events, just as a relatively new guy, just because the experience you get is just insane. Now, that was a couple of carts. I believe they went two wide, maybe three wide in that corner, went off track. So we picked up three positions just right there. And again, you know, Warbly's right behind me, and we're just trying to catch now the next group. So the front three, four guys got in a train, and they were just gone. I mean, those guys were fast. So I knew we weren't going to be able to catch up to them, but I thought, you know, getting out of the rear pack, hopefully we can get up with the middle pack and hopefully have a decent finish. So Monticello. This turn that we're about to enter right here is called Fonzio. It's got a good elevation change, sweeps to the right. You know, really when you're taking this corner, you want to be about a half cart away from the edge and try not to enter that corner too aggressively too soon. If not, you'll do what Warbly did, where you're having to bounce back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and you just end up losing a lot of time. You know, we're coming out of the chicane right here, coming into this real tight right-hander. There is a depression on the right-hand side of that track, so you want to kind of stay off of that barrier, that blue and white curbing there, or else you're going to hit it and you'll lose a lot of time. There's a lot of little things about this track. I mean, right here is the showcase going down one of the straightaways. Again, going into this really tight right-hand turn. If you don't take that turn correctly, you can lose a lot on exit speed if you bind up the car, so you just got to be really careful. Right here, we go through a quick little switchback S, and right here, you're pretty much flat out, and I know I was playing with gearing, and it would be about right here is where I would start banging off my rev limiter really, really bad. You know, when the track was a little tighter, I wasn't hitting it as early, but as the day went on, I had to adjust my gearing a little bit just because it was kind of hard for me to gauge when I was going to be banging off that thing. So, again, coming into that chicane right there, that's a very, very technical turn. Again, you can lose a lot of exit speed if you take it incorrectly. Going back into that turn right there with the depression. compression right there next to the curb. You want to miss that as much as possible. Again, you know, this is a fun event. This is a great track. This is only the second time CKNA has utilized Monticello. You know, the joke being, it's probably one of the best tracks in Florida. Facilities aren't the greatest, but as far as the track is concerned, it was done professionally. It's not a parking lot track. I mean, this track was designed by people in the Formula 1, 2, and 3 community, had input and design on this track. So it's absolutely a fantastic track. It's very well thought out, very well laid out, and it's just a fast track for a 206. It's a drafting track, but it's a blast. So again, coming out of Fonzio, keep that half card if you can away from that right grass line. If not, you're going to bind up real bad. It's just going to kill your exit speed. I tend to go really deep into this turn, probably a little deeper than maybe I should, but I tend to catch a lot of people in that turn, so I don't know if that was quite working for me or not. I know right now this is where my trouble started. So Warbly goes ahead and initiates the pass. As I was coming out of that chicane, I heard a loud click noise, and then all of a sudden I hit the throttle and I had no throttle. I thought I popped the chain. And then as soon as my tire left the asphalt, I think the chain popped back on. But unfortunately, you know, just having that momentary lapse of having the chain on there, I lost some speed. Warbly went ahead and picked me off, rightfully so. But again, I'm back up to Warbly again with the gearing. I think I was geared a little bit better than he was going into this final. I was able to suck up to him pretty easily. Again, I'm starting to back off in here on Fonzio, just because the way he takes that turn, he's just kind of all over the place. You know, nothing on him. He's just new to this track. Here is where we come into the next issue. So I come in here and initiate a pass on Warbly. Again, I'm trying to get up front. At that point, he hooks my rear bumper with his front bumper. And at this point, I don't realize it, but my left bumper is dragging on the ground, and the right side of the bumper is actually tucked up against the wheel. So I have no power right now, and I don't realize it. I don't know that my kart is that damaged. And so here I am going, and I'm thinking in my head, why am I going so slow? I mean, with the motor noise, I just couldn't hear it. I didn't know my bumper was dragging. You know, the guy up there on the tower right there just realized it. But all of a sudden, I'm just realizing I've got nothing. I've got no power, and everybody is just catching me and passing me. And I'm sitting here as a new guy, kind of scratching my head because I'm thinking, God, what is going on with my cart? I know I popped the chain. I know the chain mysteriously popped back on, but why am I having this issue all of a sudden? You know, Warbly ended up hooking bumpers by accident. It's a racing incident. I don't blame him at all. Fantastic guy. I know he wouldn't do anything like that on purpose. But it happened, and that just kind of, my final kind of just started walking away from me. Again, at this point, I'm about to come out of this turn, and I'm about to look over to the right side, and that's when I realized that the bumper is hooked against my tire. And I don't know the left side of the bumper's dragging, but I see the right side of the bumper up against the tire. And so I'm driving with one hand, trying to reach back with the other hand, trying to push that bumper out. It just, to no avail. I'm a sitting duck. Again, coming right now, we're about to take the sweeping turn into the showcase, and here it comes. First time it's ever happened. Black flag. My race is done. So anyway, that's a spin around Monticello. CKNA South, Masters Division. My racing was horrendous, but had a good time. And I really appreciate the organization. Look forward to doing it again. Hopefully lessons learned. But yeah, my weekend was officially over. All right, guys, thanks for showing up. Thanks for checking out the channel. Remember to like and subscribe, and we'll catch you on track. Thanks again.